Rudev, can you please introduce yourself?
My job is to introduce everyone to themselves.
Did I choose you, or does the guru choose his disciple?
There is no choice here.
Gurudev, can you please introduce yourself?
My job is to introduce everyone to themselves. So we get to know everybody else, we don't get to know ourselves. And so that's my job, is to introduce everyone to themselves. What do you think? Good?
Gurudev, what is the goal of the spiritual path?
Goal of spiritual path is two, Shreyas and Prayas. Shreyas means comfort in the world here, and Prayas is the ethereal, eternal comfort, or the higher goal of life, higher elevation in life. Unless you have all that you need here, your basic needs are not taken care, you cannot aspire for something higher. So, the spiritual path is that which makes you realize that there are higher goals than the basic needs of life, and take you towards that, which gives you ultimate or total freedom.
Gurudev, what is the role of guru on the spiritual path, and what is the role of the disciple?
You have already said it. You ask a question and Gurudev is there to answer. You have bondage, Gurudev is there to relieve you from bondage. And so, role of a guru is as clear as the role of a mother. If you ask someone, what is the role of the mother? It is so obvious. Mother is there to nurture, nourish, and make someone grow in the material world. Guru is there to make you grow in wisdom.
Gurudev, did I choose you, or does the guru choose his disciple?
There is no choice here. We get into the choiceless awareness. As far as the wisdom is concerned, the time comes, it is simply a choiceless thing. Everything falls in place. Now, whether a guru chooses the disciple or disciple chooses guru is immaterial. Sometimes this, sometimes that. It appears like that. Like people in the prison, our teachers, some many of you go there, you teach them. You went to give them the knowledge. Then their life blossomed, right? And there are others who kept searching for the wisdom and then they come. So it is both ways. Only you can tell whether you chose or you were chosen. But one thing you must know, anyone on the path of wisdom should know, they are chosen ones.
Gurudev, sometimes people are reluctant to come to spiritual path because they think they lose their individuality. So is it that when you are on the spiritual path?
As it is, they are in such an illusion because they have no individuality. Inside them is a crowd. When you come to spirituality, your real individuality will blossom. Because it's like all the energy in you get focused. It becomes like a laser light. You realize who you are. Otherwise, there is just a crowd inside of you. You are a bundle of ideas, thoughts, opinions of people. But when you are in spiritual path, you are not football of others' opinion. That identity changes, no? And that is where true individuality shines.
Gurudev, I have a question. Arth, Arthi, Jignasu or Jnani, are all these four sectors equal to the Guru?
Artho, Arthi, Jignasu, Jnani, all four are equal to Guru. For Guru, it doesn't matter whether one is coming to relieve oneself of the pain or suffering, or one is coming to seek some wisdom, or if one is already a wise person. For Guru, everybody is the same. It's like the cereal bulbs, which has different colors. For the electricity, it doesn't matter what color of bulb it is. All different color bulbs are there, but electricity only makes them all glow.
in spiritual path which is rated higher, sympathy or empathy, compassion or kindness?
Spiritual path doesn't rate anything higher or lower. It just sees them all as different flavors of your own consciousness.
Can achieving the highest grace or blessings of the Guru be as simple as being in gratitude?
Gratitude is something that spontaneously comes with you. You cannot force a gratitude. So when gratitude arises in you, that means you are complete. See, if you lack something, then that gratitude cannot come up. So it's a gratitude which makes you whole, complete.
How can we cultivate the frequency and the duration of that Guru Shakti within us?
See, your run to improve yourself is your problem. See, I want to improve myself. Why do you have to improve yourself? Why don't you accept yourself as you are? So once you accept it, you will see you get access to many talents that are already hidden inside of you. Because we are running, we are trying to compete. When we see others, when we want to be better than them, we want to be the, you know, this idealizing in the mind puts you on a back foot. That moment you drop all your idealism, this is little higher knowledge. So the moment you say, I just accept me and my situation as it is, coming to the very basic point, something happens inside of you. Then you are in this state of total contentment. And talents which are hidden in you, they start manifesting. And even if they don't manifest, you don't care. you are happy. See, when a lamp is glowing, there is no half glow or less glow or more glow. Lamp is glowing and glowing, that's all. It spreads its radiance all around it. And that's what we must remember, that each one of us are a glowing lamp. And so we radiate ourselves. This does not mean that you shut your ears to others' inputs. You know, it can lead you to arrogance also. That is where a yogi falls. So arrogance need to be avoided at all costs. How it can happen? It can happen when you remember simplicity in life and open to any type of criticism. No need to justify or resist or defend yourself when criticized. Isi ko kehte hain jab bilkul ek sukhe patte ke jaise reh jao. Sukha patta kya hai? Jahan hawa jaati wahan pahunch jata hai. उसको अपना कोई आग्रह नहीं है, किसी प्रकार का आग्रह नहीं है, तनाव नहीं है, भेद नहीं है, और दूसरों का जो भी होता है वो सुनते भी हैं।
गुरुदेव, from what you've said just now, and you've said this before, that there are two paths in spirituality, the way of the cat or the kitten and the way of the monkey, where the guru takes responsibility or the shishya holds on to the guru. Thank God you held on to me, Gurudev. Where should one hold on? Where should one let go?
It is the time, situation, and your tendencies will lead you to that. Either you are a kitten or you are a monkey. When you have total faith, then you are a kitten. When you feel helpless, you become a monkey.
Should we take the vaccine or not?
You know, this question become irrelevant if you have already taken vaccine.
Gurudev, earlier you said that it makes no difference to the electricity what bulb it lights up. Would it be okay for the bulb to even aspire to be the electricity at some point? Or should the bulb remain the bulb and forget about being electricity?
No, without electricity, bulb has no value. Bulb is all the external. You are not the external. But the electricity inside the bulb is what really is the substance. So you have to realize that you are the electricity.
Gurudev, you just mentioned about a state of having no desires. At the same time, we were talking about having a goal also. Don't they contradict?
Oh yeah. Truth is contradictory. You have to have both. You have to have a vision, a goal, and then you have to drop it. That is what the secret of sankalpa. You know, in all the pujas and everywhere, what do we do in India? We take sankalpa. Sankalpa is, oh, at this point of time in space, I take this intention, and then you drop that intention. Because life cannot move without a direction. So you need to give it a direction.
Why do you need to drop that intention? If anyway the intention is what is driving
you. Otherwise you'll go crazy. The difference between an intention and desire is, in desire you are holding on to it, you become so feverish and you lose all your energy, power in holding on to it. When you drop it, that intention anyway will work. You have an intention, you are not negating. See, there is a difference between dropping and negating. See, when you start a car, you don't keep the ignition on the whole time. You use the ignition, but then the vehicle moves when you drop that. In the same way, intention to be taken and dropped. Now, negation is a very different thing. Negation is, oh, I should not have this. So you are negating the desires.
Conflict, dispute, confrontation is inevitable. On whose side is the guru, number one? Number two, what does the victorious party did to access the guru?
You have already answered your own question. Guru is on the side of the victory.
Yeah, but that's not evident when the conflict begins.
Ha! It will not be evident, because the thrill will be finished. So it keeps the thrill and the juice in the whole episode alive.
And how does a victor access the guru?
The fact that he is in the path to victory, the guru is already there.
Gurudev, is there a qualification to receive grace? Because it doesn't seem to grace everyone's lives equally.
It's a sort of catch-22. If you are grateful, you get the grace. And if you get the grace, then you will be grateful. It's like that. So that is why in the ancient scriptures it is said, three things are very, very difficult to get. Human birth, and then the path, inclination in the knowledge, and then the company of the master or grace. And when you get these things, you already have enough merits. For a seeker, Guru Purnima is the day to reflect where I would have been if the knowledge was not available to me. So this question, this pondering will help someone to feel more grateful where they are, and also it motivates someone to do something better. Either you feel, oh, I have wasted my whole year, didn't do much, or I have done so much good. In either case, it helps you to move forward. If you feel you have wasted your whole year, did nothing, that also helps you to wake up. And when you realize that you have been bestowed with so much of wisdom and grace and blessings you have received in your life, that makes you more grateful and still make you move forward.
Once you are on the path, you are already a victor. Now, under the same guru, there is appearance of conflict between the same people, different people, in the same path. Then one is a failure there. Does that mean that person did not have a guru?
No. See, if it appears that someone has not succeeded, you should know every failure is a step towards success. It is not yet their time, but they will still move forward. They have learned something. In life, there is nothing called failure. Only in the events, on a short-term gain, you may look, oh, this is failure, this is success. On a long-term, in a bigger picture, that's not the case. See, when a baby walks, it falls 10 times. Some baby may fall 20 times before it starts walking. But that you can't call it failure. Eventually, everybody will walk.
So, guru is on both the sides of the two conflicting people.
Yeah. Even in the tough time, the master was there with them, helping them to learn more and walk better.
So does that mean there's no escape from the spiritual path?
According to me, no, but people think.
Gurudev, if knowledge is already within us, but we still need the master, what exactly does the master do and how does he do it?
The filament is already in the bulb. It just needs electricity to flow. Like that. A bud has everything it needs to become a flower, but still a bud needs little nurturing. It needs some more water, some more sunlight, then it will blossom.
Gurudev, can mumukshatva come through effort or is it a blessing?
Mumukshatva means seeking comes with awareness, or seeking comes with when you are fed up of what you have and when you think things are binding you. When you realize everything is a bondage, then the desire for freedom arises in you. It has to come from maturity.
What is the best way to express gratitude to the Guru?
That your heart will tell you, I want to express this way, then you express that way. In fact, it is inexpressible. If you ask me, however you express it, still you find it's not the best way. If you feel that, then it is the best way.
Gurudev, I have one personal regret. Why didn't I get you earlier in my life? So much difference has happened. And then I have a regret for others because I find so many friends and people I know who really want to come, but there's some mundane things that put them off. What to do?
First of all, there are many different people on the planet. Our job is to, like a farmer, what does he do? He has plowed the field and he sows the seed. He does not go and pick whether each seed has grown or not. So that much only we can do. You know, there is the proverb, no, you can take the horse to the water but cannot make it drink. In the same way, all that we could do, we could give people an access to the joy, the wisdom that we have enjoying, and beyond that, it is their karma. We have to leave it to them.
But then, does every disciple who comes to a master reach the destination?
In this, there are three categories: the mild, moderate, and the intense one. The intense one will get it soon. The moderate will move. The mild one, we may take a couple of more lifetimes. But anyway, everybody will be on the path. Maybe in the, may not be a couple of more, maybe in the very next itself.
And in the context of the guru and disciple relationship, is there something that makes a guru happy and is there something that disappoints him?
No. The guru doesn't get, he never takes appointment nor disappoints.
Gurudev, it is easy to relate to the Guru in the form, but how to understand the Guru as a principle?
Are you form or are you formless? How do you want people to relate to you? To your form or your formless nature? As a person, you look into yourself, am I form or am I formless? You are in some way both. So whatever the shape, color, stature or stage of life we are in, how we would like others to relate to us? As an outer person or as a human being, in something more than that. You always see that people should see you as something more than what your physical appearance. Right? You relate to someone beyond their appearances. That means to some degree everybody is only connecting to the formless. Why someone cannot relate to a corpse? Corpse is lying there. However beautiful that person has been, it's corpse. Because that something is not there anymore in it. The formless is not there. So your relationship is only with the formless. But it gives an illusion to you that you are relating to the form. If you are relating only to the form, you must be so attached to every corpse, right? Who cares for the dead body? Because the life is not there. So our relation to the life is what is the formless. Because life, you can't see life other than in the form. At the same time, without the form, you can't see the formless. That is why in this country, they have said, Guru bina gati nahi. There is no progress, there is no attainment without the Guru. Why? Because of this. But as you proceed in the spiritual path, then you start relating beyond the physical body with the presence of the Guru, with the energy. Guru is an empty space. Guru is just a mirror or a space that cannot be captured. So in this sense, you cannot put a personality to Guru. Body or personality is just like the frame, but what is inside the frame is infinite space.